like when you're watching a movie, the food that the characters are eating takes a starring role. So how about recreating some food from a film? Our next guest is way ahead of you. He spends a lot of his life in Hollywood and has one of the most delicious dishes for us this morning. Please welcome chef and friend of Studio 10, Jason Robbo.
Sarah, hello everybody.
Hi. Now, what are you making for us today?
So this is a classic cubano, which is a sandwich that is obviously synonymous with the movie Chef, which we covered in Film to Table, yes. But also very synonymous with Florida and Miami when the immigrants come over, and this Cuban sandwich was seen as like a lunch dish. But it is basically meat on meat on meat and butter cheese pickles.
And you're just back from Los Angeles where you've been working on an exciting sort of food web series, Film to Table,
which sort of embraces what we're doing today. But beyond that...
Gosh, that smells good.
Hang on a second, just let people know what we're doing here. So this is a beef.
Okay, so this is a pork shoulder. Close, another four-legged right. animal. so this is a pork shoulder, probably yes. about a 3 kilo. You guys writing this down, right?
Yes.
It'll be checking. On our website.
Oh, good, good. So 3 kilo pork shoulder. I have coriander or cilantro, oregano, and I have mint. Mm-hmm. The zest of one orange. We'll do the juice of one orange.
Okay.
The zest of one lime. The juice of one
okay.
lime.
Okay, yep, sounds good. Gosh, it smells so fresh, doesn't it?
And that's what's really delicious about yeah. Cuban food, are those flavours. Oh, thank you, Artie, you're saving the pan there.
And you've actually scored the pork shoulder as well.
So it has been scored, okay, so the flavour goes in. But generally with something like this, you're going to marinate it for like 24 hours. And this okay. is the difference between a good sandwich and a great sandwich. I see you're okay there, Lev. You're holding
yeah,
that.
Yeah, look, I all mean, right. I've always wanted a role in life in the kitchen.
All right, there you go. You hold that pan. You'd put it on the back there.
Yeah.
You can get in there.
Yeah, so you're going to add some more, some sea salt flakes, some cumin.
Oh my God, you know the recipe.
Yes.
Yeah, some cumin.
Onto the beef.
Out of that. Look, freestyle.
Oh, there we go. Oh, have you seen that yeah, salt guy? What is with
he
him?
He owns that, but how good is he?
So good. Like, do you know him?
No, I wish.
We're just going to get the producer to look it up for us now. Okay. There's a what's
Salt
he called?
Bay.
Salt Bay.
B-A-E.
Yeah. He does this amazing kind of salting of meat. It's very theatrical.
Well, but the cutting of it as well.
Oh.
We should have had him.
Perhaps another show.
Hey, just a grinder.
Perhaps another show. We're trying to make this sandwich all better.
All right,
yeah,
look.
We should get on with this.
I use an apple grinder.
Really?
All right, so Sarah, while you're doing that, the whole idea is that to marinate it, and this is the difference between a good and a great sandwich, is that you get all those flavours in there. Let it sit for about 24 hours.
Yep.
Then into the oven, 220 degrees Celsius. Write this down, 220 degrees Celsius for about 20 to 30 minutes. Drop the temperature down to about 150 and let it cook till it reaches an internal temperature.
Yes.
Of 68.
Okay.
68
that's,
degrees.
That's very specific. We'll put it on our website.
It's on the
for
web.
You.
Okay. So, but here's what we prepared earlier.
Okay.
All right, so this goes in.
Yes.
To the pan. We're just going to warm this through a little bit. So, this is what it looks like after having cooked for, say, an hour and a half and it's chilled down. We take our pork. This here is carnitas, which is basically pork cooked in lard. So as I was saying, it's really good for you. You could use like pulled pork and reduce some of the fat content. I actually cheated with this and cooked this in my pressure cooker and it only took an hour.
Right, so but otherwise you'd use the same pork that you just baked.
Well, no, the whole idea is that you're actually doing, you're layering this. So okay. we want to warm this through. You put this back on the heat.
You ready?
And we'll flip it. Okay, wow, so just getting a little bit of warmth through it. And then once that's warmed through, and we can just take a couple of pickles.
While we heat that, should we show you Salt Bay?
Yeah, let's
have a look
do
at
it.
Salt Bay. This is something else. Have a look. Cutting of the meat. Oof.
What? That's me when I had my tan. I am Salt Bay.
Is that a Stegosaurus bone or a Brontosaurus bone? What
they,
is
they
that?
Call it a, I think it's a tomahawk.
Oh, is it?
Where they keep the whole rib on it, yeah. Very impressive.
Yeah, this is him. He's got a whole YouTube channel, doesn't he?
You know, can I tell you the reason I moved back to Australia is... Look at that.
Look at you, you're captivated
wow, that's
by
so
this.
Nice, isn't it?
Yeah, because I'm captivated because he owns so many restaurants now and he is a gazillionaire because of that. I mean, it's impressive to watch.
Yeah, it is.
It's a sharp knife.
It's a very sharp knife.
Very sharp knife.
Well, this is going really well. Now, you're also going to be doing a bike ride. Do you do a lot of bike riding?
I do a lot of bike riding, and I believe you were there at the inaugural ride last year for the Bondi to Berry. And
the whole idea
is that we're raising money for Alzheimer's and raising awareness about Alzheimer's and dementia. Last year they raised over 50,000 with 40 riders. This year we plan to raise 75,000 for 60 riders. So we're super excited. What you're seeing on TV now, though, is Chef Cycle. So, oh, there's me!
Oh, look at that guy.
Something I created for No Kid Hungry. This year, we actually raised $2 million for this ride. And we had Pink riding. Jeff Bridges is the big name and face behind No Kid Hungry. But the whole idea is we're raising money and awareness for kids, getting them fed, because one in five kids turns up to school without a meal.
Yeah, so
and we have very similar situations here in Australia.
Yeah, that's lovely. And when is the Bondi to Berry?
So the Bondi to Berry is coming up in September, early September. And
it's an early start of Bondi Beach, and it's really cold. So,
and then we ride to Berry, which is really nice because at the moment I think it's important because of the big highway that's gone past Berry to try and bring some love back to Berry. But it's a 155k ride. There are three stops. I believe Natasha Belling is doing the ride.
Yes, oh, wow.
As is, are you? You're doing the ride.
Oh, I'm pregnant. I don't think I can.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Awesome. You just thought, well, how many Cuban sandwiches has she been eating?
Baby on board.
No, I do know. You know, I wouldn't say that because, you know, I actually got busted once. Have you ever said to someone, oh my God, you're pregnant?
I know.
I got busted doing that once.
Oh no. Yeah. How did you recover?
I didn't.
It's pretty good here.
I just walked away.
Oh.
Yeah, you don't recover from that. So the whole idea now is to lift this straight onto our sandwich.
Oh my gosh.
But, so you're getting a very typical American sandwich. Let's put the rest of these carnitas on here.
Wow.
All right. And then, just because we can, we put the top on. Mm. Hey, let's put some butter on it.
Yeah, oh let's go. I mean, hell, let's do it the whole.
So, but I think it's very, I think it's
hell
very.
Hell the calories.
I think it's very fair to say this is a very Americanized style sandwich. And I think if we're talking about...
I like it big and greasy in the States.
Big and greasy. But it actually is a delicious sandwich. And the sandwich is really about the bread. And then when it's cooked, it's about the knock. You should hear a hollow sound to it. But given that we're cooking a Cuban sandwich in honor of Film to Table, I think it's important. If you're talking about Alzheimer's and dementia, we're looking at prevention as better than a cure because there is no cure right now.
No, there isn't.
So you should be eating foods like, you know, lots of nuts and walnuts. Walnuts look like a brain, it's brain food.
Yep.
Green leafy vegetables and all those sorts of things. So it's important to be conscious of what you're eating.
So Cuban sandwiches are sometimes
So we're showing you probably not what you should eat.
Sometimes you've got to have a treat.
Of course.
You have to have a treat.
It's a treat. Of course.
So this will take a couple of minutes to cook. But beyond that, I think it's important that we do make Bondi to Berry such a big ride. And then over the years, it'll grow, become bigger and bigger, and we'll raise more awareness, more money, and hopefully make a dint in the Alzheimer's
situation.
Last
year, we had Tony Abbott cycling with us.
I hope he was. I wasn't there. I don't believe... Was he wearing his budgie smugglers?
No, he's wearing the proper cycling gear that you guys all wear.
Yeah, actually, that's why I started
cycling.
He's a
great supporter of Alzheimer's Australia, Mr. Abbott.
He is. And speaking of celebrities, you've been biking with some pretty cool celebs as well.
Oh, speaking of, yes. So Pink there, right? Wow. So she had, at that point, this was only like a few months back, she had a five-month-old child. When she said yes to doing the ride, she was pregnant.
Oh.
She said, I'm going to do the ride.
And then she pressure?
Right, no pressure. She got off her bike literally every 30 to 40 miles and breastfed.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. As always, next year, Sarah.
So hang on, she was pregnant and breastfeeding?
No, so she said yes to doing the ride a year ago.
Oh,
she
okay.
was pregnant at the time.
Yes.
By the time she was doing the ride, she had had the child.
Right.
Had a five-month-old child.
Okay.
And got off the bike every 30 to 40 miles and breastfed. Her husband, Carrie, actually did the ride. As well, so really.
Sarah's really thrilled to hear all.
All right, I.
No pressure, Sarah. I do have a Bondi to Berry jersey out here with
ready?
The bump
we ready
in it.
For this yet?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Let's. Oh, look, hold on. So, wow. Item, you get down here. You just pull the hair out of it that came from the brush.
Oh. Okay. Sure, it was from the brush.
Yes. No, it wasn't mine. It was really dark. Mine's greyish. So, see, how's that?
Oh yeah.
Oh, knock it. Knock your sandwich. And then by putting it in a press, it flattens the sandwich so it doesn't look like there's as much meat in it. See?
How good.
And you pull it out there. Cooked meat, no cross contamination.
Yes.
Good. Gloves, pork.
Yep.
We did everything right, I'm sure.
Everything right.
I can tell when I was on another network doing this stuff, the amount of letters you get for cross contamination was crazy.
I know, yes.
But it can only tell them it's only television.
But I didn't even know it was a thing until like 3 months ago, so it's good that we're doing it.
Yeah. And then look, where's close up?
Should we have a taste, Ita?
Ita.
Look at that.
I am going to taste it.
Give it to Ita. That was a money shot and everything. And then Sarah.
Oh, wow.
And the best thing about this is you actually can make it gluten-free. You do a gluten-free bread. My good friend Rowe Dylan makes some.
Stop it.
Right?
That's so good.
I know. Oh, perfect pregnancy food.
Jason Roberts, everyone. Yay! Yeah. Yeah.